Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
God is said. Amen. We're looking at Proverbs chapter 23. Proverbs chapter 23. And I'm reading there from verse 7. I'm actually going to take the first part of verse 7. Proverbs chapter 23, verse 7. You see the importance of what we're talking about tonight. In Proverbs 23, verse 7, for as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. He thinks he's poor, so is he. He thinks he's weak, so is he. He thinks he's unfortunate, so is he. He thinks he's unlucky, so is he. He thinks he's hated, so is he. He thinks he's not popular, so is he. He thinks he'll never get forward, so is he. He thinks he'll never achieve, so is he. He thinks, who am I that shall enjoy life? And so is he. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. On the other hand, he thinks, I'm a child of God. I'm favored. I'm fortunate. I'm happy. I'm healed. I'm made whole. I'm promoted. I'm lifted up. Everything in my life is going to succeed. No enemy will stop me. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. I am saved. I'm going to be victorious. I'm going to get to heaven. I'm going to see the face of the Lord Jesus Christ. And between now and then, I'm going to be the happiest I can be. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. I'm talking to you tonight on thinking the thoughts of God. Thinking the thoughts of God. That is, you look at, what's God thinking about me? And I think like God is thinking about me. I don't think like I used to think. I don't think like they are still thinking. I don't think like they are wishing I should think. I just look at, what's God thinking about me? What's Jesus thinking about me? What's the Holy Ghost thinking about me? What's the Word of God saying about me? Because if I can take the thoughts of God and bring them into me and think the thoughts of God, the power of God will work in my life. If you can take the thoughts of God every moment of the day, you wake up in the morning and then you say, God, what are you thinking about today? And you get the thoughts of God and you put that in your heart. Then the thoughts of God will be fulfilled in your life in Jesus' name. Come back to this again, Proverbs chapter 23. We're looking at that verse 7 again, Proverbs chapter 23, verse 7. It says, for as a man, as he thinketh in heart, so is he. Will you allow me to read it for my sisters, for my daughters there? For as she thinketh in her heart, tell me, so is she. My boy, my girl in the youth section there. For as he or she thinketh in his or her heart, so is he or she. Our children, the same thing. For as a person thinketh in his heart, so is he. And let's see now, what has made the difference between the plan of God for you and where you are, the plan of God for them and where they are? Let me show you what has made the difference. We're looking at Isaiah chapter 55. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts. For my thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are your ways my ways, says the Lord. That's what makes the difference. The Lord is thinking this way. I want him up. I want him high. I want him lifted up. He is sinking this way. I cannot go up. I cannot go high. I cannot achieve. It is the difference in the thought of God and your own thought that makes you not to be who God wants you to be. If you can just, you don't have to say, I will change my destiny. Yes, that's then. But you see, changing your thought changes your inner motivation. Changing your inner motivation will change your faith. Changing your faith will change your decisions. Changing your decisions will change your talk, the talk of your mouth. Changing your talk will change your action. Changing your actions day by day will change your habit. Changing your habit will give you the victory. And so, if you say, this is where I want to go, where it starts is your thought. The thoughts leads to the inner motivation. The inner motivation leads to faith. The faith leads to the decisions to make. Your decision leads to the talk. First of all, your self-talk. The talk you have within yourself. I will get up. I will arise and go. I will study. I will take that form. I will pass that exam. I will seek for that job. You are telling yourself, but it is because your thought, therefore you are motivated, therefore you have faith, therefore there is the decision, therefore you are now talking, and then you are talking to other people. What you say to other people originates from your thought. If you say, I don't think I want to go out today, it's because you have been thinking of something else. You don't like me in that place of work. You don't like me in that district. You don't like me in that church. You don't like me in that place. So why am I going to them? They reject me. That's what you are telling yourself. Maybe they don't reject you, but that's what you think. And because of your thought, that leads to your decisions, and that leads to the talk, that leads to your action. If you're sitting down, dejected, unhappy, not moving up, not doing anything, no program, nothing, no project, nothing, leave me alone, I'm tired. It's because of your thought. That's what comes out in your action eventually. If you rise up and now you are alive, and say, let's go, we're getting there, and we're going to make it. It's because your thought changed. All you need to do is change your thought, every other thing will change. If you want to change your world, change your thoughts. If you want to change where you are now, change your thoughts. If you want to change your personality, if you are, you know, the morose type and the gloomy type, the unhappy type, and the one that is always, you know, doing something negative, hurting yourself and blocking your own way, is because of your thought. If you want to have a positive personality, and you say, we'll climb that mountain, we'll achieve that thing, we'll do that project, we'll get that thing done, and you're going to be beneficial and positive everywhere, change your thought. Everything will change in Jesus' name. A change will come when your thoughts change. Victory will come when your thoughts change. Success will come when your thoughts change. Healing will come when your thoughts change. Deliverance will come when your thoughts change. You'll be on top of the world. You have dominion. You will reign in this life. I said you'll reign in this life. When your thoughts change, if you think I can, you can. If you think you will, you will. If you think I must, you must. If you think I will get there, you will get there. It doesn't matter where you are now. It doesn't matter where you are now. It's the direction you are facing. It's the thoughts you are thinking that gets you there. You are going to get there in Jesus' name. There will be signs and wonders. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Wait, as a church thinketh. As a church thinketh. As a church thinketh in his heart. If the church can think in the same direction, if the church can think in the same positive way, as the church thinketh in his heart, so is he. This church will be strong. Yeah. This church will be mighty. Yeah. And this church will be powerful in Jesus' name. Because The difference up till now has been the difference between the way God is thinking and the way we are thinking. If we just change everything around and we think the same way with God, we will see everything God has ordained for every one of us and for every family in Jesus' name. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it to bring forth, and budge, and that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the earth, so shall my word be that goeth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish. Did I hear you say amen? It shall accomplish that which I please, and shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. This word will prosper in your life. We're looking at Jeremiah chapter 29. Jeremiah chapter 29, and I'm reading there from verse 11. This is for you. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you. If you could think the thoughts of God, he knows the thought he's thinking about you. If you just find out what's the thought he's thinking about me, and he says, I know the thoughts that I think toward you, and you also have the same thought, thinking the thoughts of God, then you are in agreement with God, and it's going to be done. Then he says, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. To give you an expected end. It's coming. It will come in Jesus' name. There are 3 points. Number one, the message is thinking the thoughts of God. Thinking the thoughts of God. Point number one, thinking of his divine power. Thinking of his divine power. God never thinks in weakness. Never, God never thinks, oh, if I could do that, I would have done it. God never thinks, if I could bless that person, I would have blessed him. But I can't. But I can't. God never thinks in weakness. God never thinks in reference to Satan. He never thinks, I would have done this except because this Satan will not allow me to. He never thinks like that. God never thinks in respect or in reference to demons. God doesn't say, I would have done this in the world, in this person's life. But for these demons, they're so strong and they're so scattered everywhere. God never thinks with any point of reference to the demons. God never thinks with the philosophy or the resistance of man. God never says, I would have done this, but Pharaoh will not allow me. I want to take these people out of the land of Egypt, but Pharaoh will not permit it. God never says, well, I would have delivered Sadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but the fire of Nebuchadnezzar is too strong, it's too hot. God never thinks in reference to other people. When you think the thoughts of God, you will think in terms of his power, in terms of his ability, in terms of his promise that this is what God says he will do. You will not be thinking in reference to this or that or that, or even in reference to yourself, saying, well, why, if not for this, maybe God would have been able to work, but I think I'm the hindrance. I think I'm too stubborn for God. I think I'm too weak for God. I think I'm too ignorant for God. I'm unintelligent. God never thinks in with respect or reference to that. If you will think the thoughts of God, you think according to his power, and something will change in your life. It's changing already. I said it's changing already, because you wake up tomorrow and it doesn't matter how you feel. You feel strong, you feel otherwise, God is still God. You are here, you are there, God is still God. And God says, I know the thoughts I think towards you. And it's a thought of peace, and he says, he will give you the expected end, and that expected end, it will happen in Jesus' name. Because you see, God is so mighty, and God is so great. And you think in the almightiness of God, you think in the power of God, you think in the ability of God, and that's exactly what God will do. Point number one, thinking of his divine power. Number two, talking only of his definite promise. You see, it's your thinking that will bring what you talk about. Because out of the abundance of the heart, tell me, the mouth speaking, what you speak out reflects what you have been thinking about. If you say, I think, you know, people are unreliable, they won't allow me to succeed. You've been thinking of something. You've been thinking, change that thought, you will succeed. I said, change that thought, you will succeed. You'll succeed in Jesus' name. You see, it's not them, it's you. It's the way you are thinking. And it's, you think, I'm backward. That's why you are backward. As a man thinketh in his heart, so you see. You say, I'm unlucky. That's why you're unlucky. It's not they that make you unlucky. It's you that makes yourself unlucky, because that's what you say. But if you will say the talk of your mouth, and you talk according to his definite promise, and say, praise the Lord, things are different now. You'll find me on the mountaintop. That's where I will find you. You'll find I passed my exam. That's exactly what you are going to find. You will find that I am stronger. You'll find that I am well and healthy and strong. That's exactly what is going to happen. Number two, talking only. Well, you cannot talk the talk of God according to his promise. Just keep quiet. You just keep, because when you keep quiet, that thought will die. The negative thought will die. I said it will die. Have you seen people, let's say for example, their hand is good and strong and healthy, and there's nothing wrong with their hand, and then they put a sling on their neck and they hang the hand like this. If they just hang it, nothing wrong with it, they just hang it there 1 week, 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. If they just hang it like that and they don't give it any activity, what will happen? Your hand will die. So that thought, just hang it there. Don't you won't fight it, just leave it there. Or don't say it out. And then you only say the positive, you only say the one that is good, and then the other negative, you are just hanging there. By the time you come there, 1 week or 1 month after that, that negative thought is dead. And all those negative thoughts are dead in your life in Jesus' name. Don't give voice to anything negative. It will still come. It will be like a bird flying over your head. Don't give it activity. Don't give it any voice. Hang it there. It will die in Jesus' name. And then when there's a positive thought according to the promise of God, say that out, because what you say, you will have. Number two, talking only of his definite promise. Number three, taking up your daily double portion. You'll take it. I said you'll take it. Taking up your daily double portion. The king, from the time of John until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. This is mine. And Satan says, who are you? You don't know me. I'm a child of God. I'm a man under authority. I say unto this, go, and he goeth. And I say unto this, come, and he cometh. And I say unto you, release my blessing. Get out of that place. That thing is mine. And then you take it. What happens? You will have it. The kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. This night, you stand according to the word of God. Your full strength, you square your shoulder, you adjust your shirt, you adjust your skirt, or what do they call it now? Your dress, whatever you have, and then your eyes are awake, your mind is alert. Because I'm a man under authority, I'm a woman under authority, and I say unto this, go, what will happen? And I say unto this, blessing, come, what will happen? Because now it is what you say that matters. Not what they say, not what they do, but what you say that matters. It will happen in Jesus' name. And so, taking up your daily double portion, I take mine. I said, I take mine. I said, I take mine. Number one, what's number one? Thinking of his divine power. How do I sing? How do I sing that makes me victorious? How do I sing that makes me successful? How do I sing that makes me powerful? How do I sing that makes me unconquerable? How do I sing that makes me so successful and so happy? Let's look at Genesis chapter 14. Genesis chapter 18, rather. Genesis chapter 18, I'm reading from verse 14. Genesis chapter 18, and we're reading from verse 14. 18, 14, see what God himself said, and this is how to think. Genesis chapter 18, verse 14 says, is anything too hard for the Lord? Give me an answer. No. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Again, is anything too hard for the Lord? No. At the time appointed, I will return unto thee according to the time of life, and Sarah shall have a son. Sarah was already 89 years of age, 89, and God said, there's nothing too hard for me. And because of that, this is what will happen. That's why you are telling the Lord what you are thinking. You know, your thought, well, this happened, well, this happened, well, that happened. You think in reference to the power of God, thinking of his divine power. In Numbers chapter 23, Numbers 23, I'm reading from verse 19. Numbers 23, and we're reading from verse 19. Numbers 23, verse 19. You think according to this. That's your thought. That's what you change your thoughts to. Verse 19 says, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. As he said, and shall he not do it? Or as he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Behold, I have received commandment to bless, and he has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. Balaam said, I cannot reverse it. The false prophet said, I cannot reverse it. The soothsayer said, I cannot reverse it. The one that was employed, hired to curse you, said, I cannot reverse it. The way they have talked, think like that, that I know that God has given me the promise and God has given me the blessing, and no man can reverse it. Think according to his divine power. In 2 Kings chapter 7, 2 Kings chapter 7, change your thoughts. Change your thoughts. Let your thoughts line up, agree with the word of God, with the prophecy, and with the promise of the Lord. In 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1, then Elisha said, hear ye the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord, tomorrow, about this time, everybody say tomorrow. Everybody say tomorrow. Tomorrow about this time shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel, and 2 measures of barley for a shekel in the gate of Samaria. There had been famine for about 3 years, and now here the man of God said, don't worry about it anymore. All these problems that have been for 3 years, tomorrow everything will change. Tell your brother there, tomorrow everything will change. Tell the sister by your side, tomorrow everything will change. It will change. It will change. It has changed in Jesus' name. Then a Lord on whose side the king leaned answered the man of God and said, behold, if the Lord will make the windows of heaven, might this thing be? This man did not know how to keep quiet. I think there are times, if you don't understand, just keep quiet. If you don't agree, just keep quiet. If you don't know that it will be, because it will be. I said it will be. I said it will be. If you didn't know it will be, why don't you just keep quiet? The man, he killed himself with a smile. He killed himself with a smile. The blessing came, but he didn't taste of it. And thank God, I'm going to enjoy this blessing. I'm part of this blessing. I'm going to enjoy it in Jesus' name. Where are you? I said, where are you? You'll enjoy it in Jesus' name. Look at this. And he said, behold, thou shalt see it with thine eyes. Tell me, but shall not eat thereof. You know the story. It was exactly like that. He should have been thinking in God's power, but he was thinking with human weakness. He thought, but look at what we have gone through. How can this be? How can this be? What it will be. I said, but it will be Job chapter 36. And thank God in my life it will be. In my life it will be. In my life it will be. In your life it will be in Jesus' name. Job chapter 36. Job chapter 36. Verse 5. Behold, God is mighty. That's how to think. That's how to think. My God is mighty. He is my Father. He is mighty. He is my shepherd. He is mighty. He is my strength. He is mighty. He is my security. He is mighty. He is the one who has given me the promise. He is the first and the last, the beginning and the last. And because of that, he is mighty and he is my God. He despises not any. He is mighty in strength and wisdom. Verse 11, if they obey him and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure. Look at that verse. That verse is for me. I said, look at that verse. That verse is for me. It is for you in Jesus' name. Chapter 42 of Job. Chapter 40. This is how to think. This is how to think. You think in God's power. You think in the divine power. Don't ever think in your own weakness. Don't think in human inability. This is what they say. They say it's impossible. They say they cannot do it. They say nobody can get that today. They are thinking in human weakness. But you're thinking God's ability and divine power. Job chapter 42, verse 2. I know that thou canst do everything. Everything. Everything in my family, I know you can do it. Everything in my place of work, I know you can do it. Everything in my local church, I know you can do it. Everything in my family, in my children, my wife, my husband, my daddy, my mommy, I know you can do it. You will do it in Jesus' name. I know that thou canst do everything, and there is no thought that can be withholding from thee. That's how to think. That's how to think. We're looking at Jeremiah chapter 32. Jeremiah chapter 32. And we're reading from verse 17. Jeremiah chapter 32. We're looking at verse 17. In verse 17 it says, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heaven and the earth by thy great power and stretch out arm, and there is nothing too hard for thee. That's how to think. That's how to think. When there's any challenge, when there's any situation, you say, but I know God. He's a mighty God. He made the heavens and the earth, and there's nothing too hard for him. We're now coming to the New Testament in Matthew chapter 19. Matthew chapter 19, and we're reading from verse 26. When you face a new situation, when you face a new challenge, this is how to think. Remember, it is your thought. It is your thought that either makes you have dominion, or your thought that gives you defeat. That's why you change your thought and you are thinking in God's power. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. It says, Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men, this is impossible, but with God, tell me, all things are possible. That's how to think. That's how to think. Any situation, are you sick? But with God, all things are possible. Are you depressed or pressed? But with God, all things are possible. Are you barren? You are not barren anymore. I say you are not barren anymore, because with God, all things are possible. That place where you are, the blessing will reach you there. Because with God, all things are possible. We're looking at Mark chapter 9, Mark chapter 9, verse 23. And Jesus said unto him, if thou canst only believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. That's how to think. And since I believe, all things are possible. Since I believe, all things are possible. Do I believe? Are you there? Do you believe? Do you believe? Why are you crying if you believe? No more crying. I said no more crying. No more sorrow. No more regret. You will not give up. I said you will not give up. This thing, we're going to achieve it. This place, we're going to get there. Because if thou canst only believe, all things are possible for him that believeth. It is done in Jesus' name. Luke chapter 1. Luke chapter 1. I'm reading verse 37. Luke chapter 1. This is how to think. You think with reference to God's power. Think with reference to God's power. Thinking the thoughts of God. In Luke chapter 1, verse 37. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. Brother, that thing you spoke about last year, are you still praying about, I've given that up, I've given that up, because I just feel that there's no point again. Sir, look at what has happened. Look at my age. Look at this, and look at this, and look at this report, and look at this report. And since this came, I just said, okay, forget about it. But if we can only believe, I said, if we can only believe, I said, if we can only believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. That's why I come to tell you tonight, come back to the place of faith. Come back to the platform of faith and say, yes, Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe. Tell me that. Tell me that again. It will happen. I said it will happen. Verse 45. And blessed is she that believeth, for there shall be a performance of those things which were told her from the Lord. There shall be a performance. In your life, there shall be a performance. In your business, there shall be a performance. In your family, there shall be a performance. In our church here, I don't need to run here and run there, because in this place, there shall be a performance in Jesus' name. You think of him as your savior. Think of him as your healer. Think of him as your sanctifier. Think of him as your deliverer. Think of him as your redeemer from the curse. No curse in your life anymore in Jesus' name. Think of him as your helper. He will help you. Think of him as your baptizer. If you have not been baptized in the Holy Ghost, before this new year runs out, you are baptized in Jesus' name. Think of him as your teacher and your guide. You say, I don't know how to take a decision. I always say, make a mistake. In fact, I don't even worry anymore. I just take any decision because I know I will normally make a mistake. All that is gone in Jesus' name. He is your teacher. He is your guide. He will guide you in the right direction in Jesus' name. Think of him as your defender, as your protector, as your shepherd. And think of him as your supplier. Think of him as your sufficiency. If you're thinking of his divine power like that, the thought you think will bring you up and lift you up and exalt you, and you will achieve in Jesus' name. Remember, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Point number two. What's point number two? Talking only of his definite promise. Talking only of his definite promise. Talking only of his definite promise. You see, when you think of the promise of God, you talk of the promise of God, that is what is going to be done in your life. And let's see in Second Corinthians chapter 4, verse 13. We're looking at this in verse 13. It says in verse 13, we have in the same spirit of faith. Do I have the same spirit of unbelief? What do you have? The same spirit of faith. We have in the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed, therefore have I spoken. I believe, therefore have I spoken. We also believe and therefore speak. You speak what you believe. If you believe you are saved, speak it out. You believe there's sanctification, speak it out. You believe the power of the Holy Ghost is your life, speak it out. You believe you are healed by his stripes, I am healed, speak it out. You believe by the anointing all my yokes are broken, speak it out. You believe that if you have this word of the book of the law in your mouth, and you observe to do it and to meditate upon it day and night, you will make your way prosperous and you are going to have good success. Speak about it. Success is yours in Jesus' name. It says, I believe, therefore have I spoken. Speak what you believe. We're looking at Acts of the Apostles chapter 27. Acts 27 in verse 25, I believe. I believe. Look at this, chapter 27 of Acts, verse 25. Wherefore, sirs, be of good cheer. Don't cry for me. Be of good cheer. Don't cry for yourself. Be of good cheer. Don't cry for our family. Be of good cheer, sirs. Be of good cheer, for I believe God. He spoke it out. He spoke it out. Speak yours out, and it will happen in Jesus' name. He said, I believe God that it shall be. No shadow of doubt. It shall be. There's no confusion in my mind. It shall be. It shall be even as it was told me. It will happen. I said it will happen. And because it will happen, that's why you speak it out. And look at this. Ezekiel chapter 12. Ezekiel chapter 12. As we look at this, Ezekiel chapter 12, it tells us very clearly. Ezekiel chapter 12, verse 28. Therefore say unto them, thus says the Lord God, there shall none of my words be prolonged anymore. There shall none of my words be prolonged anymore. But the word which I have spoken shall be done, says the Lord God. Hey, look at Romans chapter 4. Romans chapter 4. You are called to see sweet, be not as though they were. You will not fear anything. You just look straight at your condition, at your situation. You say, I believe God, it is going to be. We're looking at Romans chapter 4. Romans chapter 4. I read there from verse 16. It says, therefore, it is of faith that it might be by grace to the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed. Everyone, and you are included. I said you are included. Not to that only which is of the law, the Jews, but to also which is of faith, of the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all, as it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations before him whom he believed, even God, who quickeneth the dead, listen to this, and calleth those things which be not as though they were. Before you see them, you say, it has happened. Before you feel it, you say, it has happened. Before you know it, you say, it has happened. Calling those things which be not as though they were. Who begins to believe in hope? That he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. And be not weak in faith. I'm talking about you now. And be not weak in faith. He considered not his own body now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but he was strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully persuaded. Are you persuaded? And being fully persuaded. Are you fully persuaded? Are you persuaded? Are you persuaded? That all those things will be running after, and you missed it, that you are getting everything in Jesus' name. And being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. Able also to perform. God is able. I say God is able. He will do it in your life in Jesus' name. Point number three, taking up your daily double portion. Taking up your daily double portion. It's like, you know, maybe you saw a doctor, and then the doctor said, now you take this in the morning. He said, if you will just do this. You take this in the morning, one here, one there, and then drink a glass of water, no problem. You'll be strong the rest of the day. When you wake up tomorrow morning again, daily portion, you take this again, and then he tells you that everything will be all right. And now, more than a doctor, all the Almighty God is saying, this is it. Take this one. I said, take this one. You'll be strong all the days of your life in Jesus' name. Daily portion, faith and freedom, double. I said, faith and freedom, double. Daily portion, healing and health, double. Daily portion, blessing and breakthrough, double. Daily portion, deliverance and dominion, double. Daily portion, holiness and wholeness, double. Daily portion, grace and gifts, double. Daily portion, purity and power, double. daily portion, anointing and authority, double. Daily portion, mastery and miracles, double. Daily portion, protection and prosperity, double. Daily portion, wisdom and wonders, double. Daily portion, vision and victory, double. Take that. It is mine. I said it is mine. I said it is mine. You take it. You take it every. Nobody can cheat you out of success in this coming year in Jesus' name. Look at Matthew. Matthew chapter 11. Matthew chapter 11, verse 12. Matthew chapter 11. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. I do remember this young man. His name is David. He was just on the field, and the father called, Jesse called him, David, David. Yes, daddy, here I am. Take all this and then go see your brothers on the battlefield. See how they do and give me information. He said, yes, daddy. And then he got there. When he got there, before he saw his brother, somebody showed up. He called his name Goliath. As Goliath showed up, he began to brag. And David forgot the little thing he was told to do. He said, there's a greater assignment. I just wanted to see Eliab and my brother and give them this. This is more than I thought. And everybody was, you know, hiding away from Goliath. And he said, this is national disaster. This is national problem. Something has to be done. And there was no volunteer. And he said, I will do it. I said, I will do it. I said, I will do it. And then he began to ask questions. He said, what will be done to the man that takes up? They said, don't ask the question. Nobody can touch this man. He said, he's been a warrior from his youth. He said, how about me? They said, you are just beginning life. He said, yes, I'm going to begin now. This young man said, okay, even though he's been, I'm just beginning. It's a new beginning. It's a new era. And because the new beginning, I'm going to do. They took him to Saul. And then Saul said, oh, my boy, thank you very much for your intention. Thank you very much for your dedication. But you see, you cannot. They will try to discourage you. They will say, you cannot do it. But you will say, I can do it. When you say, you are not able, what do you say? I am able. I am able. I am able. You are able in Jesus' name. And so this young man eventually says, all right, if you are going to go, he put his own kind of heavy yoke upon him. Take their yoke and throw it away. That thing will not work. I said, that thing will not work. He said, this one will not work. And then he took what he knew. He took a sling. And when he took his sling, then he took 5 stones, put it in the pocket, and then he looked at the enemy straight ahead, face to face. Look at them. I said, look at them. They are falling already. They are gone already. And then, as Goliath was coming, Goliath said, who is this one? He disdained him. He belittled. Don't mind what you say. It's empty talk. You are the one that has the key. You are the one having the authority. And David said, you come to me with spears and swords, but I come to you in the name of the Lord God of Israel, whom you have defied. And he said, this day, finish. I mean, the man thought about it, and then he said it out. He said, this day. Everybody said, this day. He said, this day I will show. There is no God anywhere but in Israel. And while the man was coming, then he took, that's why I said, take something, take something. He took his own sling, and then he put his stone inside. He finished the enemy. You'll finish the enemy in Jesus' name. We are on a journey to victory land. I said, we're on a journey to victory land. Don't stand still. This is not the time. This is not the day of standing still. Get to the place of action. That's what David did. He didn't just remain on the sideline. He didn't remain just. He got to the place of action. He asked questions. He answered questions. Who is that? Why is he bragging? What does he want to do? He wants to defeat Israel. And then because he asked questions, that's why the answers came. And then he got involved. get involved, get involved, because victory comes to the people that get involved. And then be willing to do something, willing to do some and face challenges. When challenges come, you know, we used to hide when challenges came in the past. In the past years, when any persecutor comes, we hide. Opposers come, we hide. Challenges come, we hide. But now there's no hiding anymore. I said there's no hiding anymore, because now we're going to face challenges. Be positive, and don't let any negative talk of Eliab, negative talk of Saul, don't let that get you down. Don't let that stop you. Think faith like David, and talk faith like David, and act out your faith like David. Do the ordinary to achieve the extraordinary. A sling, ordinary. A stone, ordinary. But then this young man took that ordinary thing and then he achieved the extraordinary. And that is what you'll do in your life in Jesus' name. What did he do? Number one, seek something. Seek something. You see, David, he didn't just remain at the background. He was seeking something. He was seeking. Seek it until you find it. Seek it until you find it. It says, ask and shall be given you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and shall be opened unto you. Seek something. Make up your mind. Seek something. Say, this is the thing I'm seeking. Seek something. Seek it. See it. See it. See in your mind's eye. Before we even get to, you see, David saw that Goliath defeated. He said, this day I'm going to do, I'll take your head off. All that bragging head, I'll take it off. All that mouth that is bragging against the God of Israel, I'll take it off. He saw it done. He saw it done. See your victory. It is done already. I said it is done already. See your healing. It's given you already. And see the dominion. It's done already. And then say something and say it firmly. Say it. That's what David did. He said it. He sought it. Then he saw it. And then he said it out. He said, say what you believe. Don't just keep quiet. The devil is bragging, you are keeping quiet. The demons are talking, you are keeping quiet. The opposers are talking, you are keeping quiet. Your enemies are talking, you are keeping quiet. Or everybody is talking, you are. Say something and say it firmly and say, this is it. It will happen in Jesus' name. Seek it. See it. Say it. Share it. Share it. He began, he said, so don't worry about it. Can I share something with you? I was keeping the all those sheep in the field, and then a bear came, and I took care of that. A lion came. Share it. Share your testimony. Share something that will give you more courage, more conviction. Share something that will make you to know that, number one, I overcame. Number two, about this. Number three, I'm going to overcome. Will you overcome? I said, will you overcome? Share it. Share it. And share it with conviction. And then you see this this young man here, he seized it. You see, he said, let's stop talking, let's stop talking. He seized his own sling. And when he seized his own sling, he said, I know how to use it. He held it firmly. That thing you have, you've used it before to kill a rabbit or to kill a bird. Now you are using that same thing now to kill this Goliath. And this Goliath will come down in Jesus' name. The same prayer that got us salvation is the same prayer that will get us healing. The same prayer that got us salvation is the same prayer that will get us dominion. It's this same mouth we use and we confess our sins and then we believe on the just and we got salvation. That same mouth that we use in getting salvation, it is the same mouth we're going to use, and the power of God will work in our lives in Jesus' name. Therefore, you will seize that sling and there you put that thing inside that stone. That's the word of God. When Satan came to Jesus Christ in the wilderness, he said, it is written, one. He knocked him out. And then Satan came out of direction. He said, the same stone, it is written down. And then came that the third time he came and Jesus said, it is written. No other thing. It is the same stone, the word of God. It will sink deep into the forehead of that devil, of that disease. It will go away from your life in Jesus' name. And then when that is done, you take your stand. Stand. Stand where you are. Stand where you are. Stand where you are. Don't allow those Philistines and Goliath, don't let them run you out. You are standing here upon this rock. I stand. And maybe the winds will come and the floods will beat against them, but this thing will stand firm. I'm going to stand until the very end. If you will do that, you'll not be like a grasshopper. You'll be a giant. You'll be a champion. You'll be a conqueror. You'll be more than a conqueror in Jesus' name. Where are the conquerors I'm talking about? Where are the conquerors? Why don't you stand up like a conqueror, like a giant, like a champion, and say, Lord, I'm getting this done. The Lord is calling upon you to say, take your stand, take your stand. Just take your stand, whatever it is you pray about, and whatever you call the Lord for, the Lord will answer in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on now, open your mouth and tell the Lord, oh Lord, I will. Oh Lord, I will. Seek something, be very definite. This is what I seek. And then see it done and say, Lord, this is the victory, it is mine. This is the healing, it is mine. This is the dominion, it is mine. I'm going to reign in life. See it done and say it out. Just say it out and say, Lord, this is done. The promises of God are yes and amen in my life. Yes, say it and share it. And then seize it. Take hold of that sling. Take hold of that word and send it forth to the right source, to the right place where it ought to be. And it will be done. 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 Seize the day. Seize the day. Seize the day. This victory will be yours. This victory will be yours. Don't relent. Don't give up. Don't relent. Don't give up. Just say, yes, I know. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. The victory is mine. It's yours. It's yours. Sickness will not hinder you, because that sickness will go. Weakness will not hinder you. That weakness will go. Oppression will not hinder you. That oppression will leave. A curse will not take hold of your life. That curse will have to leave, because you have the final say. Sage, live my life. I don't permit any negative in my life, and the negative will not be there. Believe is now. Hold on to that word. You are the victorious one. You are the champion. You are the overcomer. You are healed. You are delivered. You are blessed. You are prospered. Every good thing you open your mouth to tell, to say, according to the word, it's done. It's done. It's done. Be confident about it. David was confident about what he said. He knew beyond any shadow of doubt, this is going to be. And it was so. He had the final say. You have the final say about your life. You have the final say about your life. You have the final say about your life. Be very clear about it. Seek something. Just leave it loose. Whatever God wants, let Him give me. Be definite about it. Seek something and see it. In Jesus' name we pray. Champions, where are you? In Jesus' name we pray. Victorious children of God, where are you? In Jesus' name we pray. It shall be. I said it shall be. I said it shall be. It shall be even as it was told me. It has happened already in Jesus' name. Now, everything you have told the Lord tonight, the Lord has done it. I said the Lord has done it. Now be very careful. Don't cancel with your mouth what you have got with your face. Don't cancel with your mouth what you have got with your faith. As a man thinketh in his heart, so he sees. And now I think I'm a champion. Now I think I'm victorious. Now I think I am healed. Now I think I'm made whole. Now I think I'm all right. And I know it is so. I said I know it is so. Blessed is he, blessed is she that believeth. Because there shall be a performance of all those things that was told her from the Lord. Where is the blessed one? Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the blessing upon your people. I know it shall be. Lord, I know it shall be. Lord, I know it shall be. Confirm it in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, all the sins that have been confessed and forsaken, and were pleaded, the blood of Jesus, the mercy of Jesus, and the grace of God. Oh, Lord, I pray, let it be totally forgiven and forgotten in Jesus' name. Oh, Lord, we pray for those who have asked for victory in their lives, spiritual life, inner life, business life, family life. Oh, Lord, that victory grant to everyone in Jesus' name. And anyone sick, Lord, that sickness I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Let your healing come upon your people. Let your strength come upon your people. Make them whole. Lord, make them whole. Lord, make them whole. Confirm it in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray total deliverance for the oppressed, total deliverance for the afflicted, total deliverance for those who are demonized. All those powers of demons, activities of demons, I command you, demons, get out in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, let there be dominion for your people in Jesus' name. And Lord, the power to succeed, the power to get wealth, the power to our prosperity. Oh Lord, I pray you grant unto your people in Jesus' name. I pray, oh Lord, every Jericho wall is falling down. Every hindrance is taken away. All the hindrances before your people, they are broken down already in Jesus' name. The anointing you have given us here that breaks the yoke, I pray every yoke will be broken by the anointing in Jesus' name. And everything your people have demanded, everything your people have asked for, everything your people have claimed, I pray grant it unto them. Let your promises be fulfilled in every life in Jesus' name. Lord, make us giants. Make us champions. Make us achievers. Let the joy of the Lord be the strength of everyone. Confirm it, O Lord. Confirm it, O Lord. Confirm it, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody shout. Praise the Lord, it is done. I said, praise the Lord, it is done. Thank you, and God bless you.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi, the General Superintendent of the Deeperlife Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your heart. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.